levels to the to colleges, the universities. If you take an example at school level, how this is being promoted, that we know that there are a large number of Patel Tinkering Labs are being have been established. Many more are coming up. And those through the Atal Tinkering Labs, a network of strong mentors across the country has been already established. And these mentors, experts from industry, from academia, they're mentoring these little innovators from the school levels. And then coming up further are the incubation centers, venture centers, the institutions, innovation cells in the universities and institutions. This is happening because our budding professionals, the students, graduate level, undergraduate level, they take up ideas and then try to find out smart solutions for the society, for the benefit of the public at large. However, what we have observed is most of us fail in identifying the problems. Often we don't see the problems only. Don't know, maybe because the Britishers have ruled us for more than 150 years and then kind of mindset we have. I don't know whether we are carrying out the same mindset and we don't see the problems. We see, everything is all right going on, or this is something what has been created for us as a system. We need to follow it. So the basic problem we have observed over a period of time in institutions, also in colleges, that students don't find the problems. And therefore, the faculty has to play a very important role in facilitating identifying problems. A problem not necessary to be very big, not necessarily to be very, very complex, but problem could be simple, solutions could be also very simple. However, if it has got a big impact over the society, a larger impact on the society, I think the smart, simple solutions can also bring a big enterprise. And that is what we all have gathered today to listen to the Dr. Sanjay Bolpane, who has more than, I believe, 20-25 years of experience in formulation development, worked in many companies. Presently he is with the Micro Labs as Associate Vice President of Formulations and Development. I'm sure he must have developed hundreds of various formulations, and those have been commercialized and have been successful in market for many, many years. And what I know about him little, he always keep Martin's Physical Pharmacy with him at home, in the office, because these simple concepts of physical chemistry help us in solving big problems in the formulations. This is what I know about him, but I'm going to request him, to, number one, how we need to be vigilant in identifying the problem and what kind of a mindset we need, how we need to prepare, and what is the way to find out the solutions. Unless we do this, probably we won't be able to identify the problems. And therefore, today's talk is orientation in identifying problems, basically. So in his career of more than 20 years, how he faced some of the problems, and how he helped in bringing out a very smart solution and have, converted such products and services, which has captured a huge market, not only in India, but across the globe, and how his company has helped in creating a great value to the product, to the company, and the bigger he's very simple in his approach in explaining everything. So without taking much of time, I would request system to, you know, orient our faculty members, also guide our faculty members how they can assess students in identifying the problem, so that, you know, the faculty, the students would be able to come out with the more and more problems to be solved. Another request to him would be, you know, we are going to conduct ideation competition, and the announcement would be made by Dr. Arpana Madam, and also be with us, I believe, on 20th of where we are going to have the presentations of top five competitors, and the results would be announced. And that time also, I would request him to assess each problem and their solution, what students have suggested, and how they would have done better in finding out a smart solution. So I'm sure these kind of efforts, consistent efforts over a period of time, would certainly bring out best of the talent from this. And in years to come, probably maybe 1%, 2% of the enterprises we could build out of these undergraduates. The students have a lot of energy, but they need a proper direction. And if such kind of a platforms helps them in giving the right direction, probably their career, not only their, be able to provide to the others, and they would help in creating the business houses, enterprises, and providing the jobs. If this could be done, I think that is what the Atmanirbhar Bharat, what the kind of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has given this word, and this has become now buzzword across the country, and a lot of efforts are being made towards this direction. So thank you so much, and welcome Dr. Boldanya sir once again. Now it is over to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. I take the privilege to introduce to you our today's speaker, Dr. Sanjay Boldanya sir. Dr. Sanjay Boldanya sir is currently working as Senior General Manager in Formulation and Development in Micro Lab Limited, Bangalore. He has about 22 years of working experience in pharmaceutical industry and well-known academic organization. After completing B.Pharm and M.Pharm in Biopharmaceutics from Government College of Pharmacy, Karad, he stood second in merit in University for M.Pharm. He has completed his PhD in the research work entitled Development and Evaluation of Oral Platform Drug Delivery Technology from Government College of Pharmacy, Karad. Along with academic qualification, he has completed the PG Diploma course in Patent Law held by Nalsar Law University, Hyderabad, and PG Diploma in Pharma Regulatory. He has 26 patents in his name. Dr. Sanjay Boldanya sir has about 4 research papers and 14 abstracts published in well-known national and as well as international journals. Currently, he is leading the team of 45 formulation development and 100 analytical scientists. He had worked as visiting faculty at NMIMS for M.Pharm Pharmaceutics and MS Pharma Medicine, KM Hospital, Mumbai. He is approved PhD guide in Pune University. Now, I kindly request Dr. Sanjay Boldanya sir to sensitize and to guide today's workshop participants to identify the potential problems and identify the steps to solve said problems.
Okay, thank you. Arpana, can you give me permission to share the presentation?
Yes, sir. Doing that. Just check, sir. I made you presenter.
Yeah, okay. My presentation is visible, sir?
Yes, sir. It's visible.
Yeah, it is visible.
Good morning, all of you. And I'm very thankful to Principal Dr. Sawant, sir, and Dr. Arpana for giving my introduction and inviting me for your problem solving and ideation workshop. Based on my limited understanding in a particular subject area, I will try to give in this area how we can do the ideation or problem solving. And in between, if you have certain things where I should talk or I should address, or if there is some question which I can address, definitely I will come to that. So I will start from this one. When I was there during my tenure at Chandigarh in Punjab, I have seen this on the road. And this works as a substitute for a tractor. This is made up with a 1 Kirloskar engine. And when I asked them the name, then they asked, this is a Jugaad. And you know that we are, Jugaad is nothing, negative word, is a positive word. Positive word in the sense that with the minimum resources, how we can do the innovation and do the function. But now going forward and the global competition, and we are working in a regulatory scenario, and which is related to the human life. So for everything, we need approval, regulatory approval. And second, what's the problem with Jugaad? You can make something to work, but it cannot last long. You cannot do the improvement. And if you get a problem into it, you will unable to solve. Because it is not built up on a sound knowledge. Okay. This part is invisible. So there was the related to what should be your idea's basic parameters. Now we are in a pharma field, so I will consider these things particularly to pharma. First parameter is unmet need. Whatever you are working, is it unmet need to the patient or to the particular parameter? It might be process, it might be stability, it may be functional requirement, it may be patient compliance. If your solution or a product or improvement, I will come what type of ideas we can work. If it is not satisfying the needs, unmet needs, then probably your idea or your solution will not be valuable. See, you can give the idea, you can resolve the problem, but the value will not only in terms of money, value will be in terms of utility. Is it usable? Is it really giving the comfort or giving the outcome, giving the safety, efficacy or a quality, and then patient compliance? So that unmet needs, is it solving? Suppose you want to develop a new product. Is it really unmet need? Like many times, suppose you want to develop one technology for anti-migraine. Or maybe the pain. What is the unmet need? Unmet need will be the drug should act within minimum time. Now there are two options. Take a parenteral route, but every time it's not possible, the hospital might not be there, you might not be expert to administer yourself the injection. Then what is the option? Tablet. But tablet can you make a tablet rapidly absorbing within 10 minutes? Suppose you can get the at least onset to subside the pain. So whenever you come up with any problem or idea or existing problem that, okay, you want rapid onset for a diclofenac or paracetamol, it takes around 1 hour. If it is after food, then again half an hour. So this part you have to always consider whatever the product you are working. Second is now cost. Okay, first you are satisfying. Now the cost. Now if you make the paracetamol tablet, which is costing around maybe nowadays 2-3 rupees. What should be its cost? If you are making the cost of paracetamol tablet to 15 rupees, 20 rupees, 25 rupees, do you think will this idea work? Based on my understanding, it won't work. Why? Why it won't work? It's not the chronic therapy. It's not the life-saving drug. And that's why who will, and considering the options available in the market, then within that price he can take an injection also. But why he need the technology which you developed that rapidly it will act. Third, there are good things or excellent ideas people have developed with unmet need with the cost, but is it manufacturable? Manufacturable doesn't mean that whether facility is available. Manufacturable comes that can we develop the process which is a stable, controlled, predictable, and capable. If we don't able to satisfy these requisites of manufacturing processes, ultimately all the other things, quality, yield, cost, and regulatory, all depends on these requirements. Then fourth, scalability. Can I do the scale up like a dolo? So I now remember during this COVID-19, one of the major brand who sold in the market is Dolo 650. Our manufacturing facility cannot supply the market, can satisfy the market demand. So then what to do? Scale is already exhausted. Right? 10 ton paracetamol every day we are processing and making the tablet. Then parallelly, what is an options? Then we have to add an additional line that will take itself 1 year. So now if somebody has ready-made granules available, right, those can be taken to other facility where only compression machine is required. It's uncoated template. So it should have the multiple options to work on a scalability. Nowadays, COVID-19 vaccine, major problem is the scalability. Many of the R&Ds have the solutions they have developed, but scalability issue, I think only Serum in Pune and maybe Bharat Biotech can scale up to certain extent because the requirement is very huge. And last, most important is regulatory approval. If you are developing a new product or some change in a function, function means, suppose I am developing a rapid absorption technology and I am increasing its Cmax. Now I need approval in terms of safety. So whatever you do, if it is affecting the function, process and stability is okay, but function, then there you need a regulatory approval. And if your product is altogether new, then also you need the regulatory approval. So to become the idea successful, to convert the idea into I will say as a business requirement, profitable, it should satisfy this requirement. Because when we start, we should not consider only one parameter and just neglect other parameters. Then that solution or that your idea's value will not be in cash completely. So to encash it before starting, consider these parameters, consider these requirements, and then one by one build up on your ideas and see that it sees one day the sunlight and convert it into a product or a process which can be encashed, right? So now we'll ask, who will give the idea? Or who will give the problem? There are two things. Suppose if I am working in my field as a head R&D, head formulation development, every day I face a problem. And parallelly, I give the ideas also. Now, somebody may ask that, do we have the problem? I will say, yes, I have the problem. Then give it us, we'll give a solution. That is also fine, but I will take a solution from you. But as a faculty, as a student, I always say, research should be done by academicians. Then what industry people should do? They should do the development. Is it having some link? I will say yes. When research is done, when some publications comes, when I read the conclusion, it is expected that there should be some knowledge come out of that publication. That knowledge is nothing but science for me. So if you ask what is written in a book, I will say science. What is written in a journal, I will say the research. By using these things, industry person has to do the development. I am not expert in all the topics. I am expert in one topic also. Because industry, based on our regular job functions, we have to solve all type of a problem. Because we are in development, we are not in a research. So in a developmental problems, definitely it should be solved by using science and research only. But every time I will see, or in most of in, I'm quote this based on my experience, it might be true, it might be wrong, I don't know. But most of the time people goes in a first pass, that is a trial and development. This path is good. Sometimes you develop the product with the minimum time, it resolve the problem with a minimum price, but that doesn't give a complete solution. So in a trial and development, this innovation or this problem, this is not the right way. By two things, solution will not be 100% foolproof. And second, most of the things has not been considered by taking a trial. And the solution which come after trial may not be the simple solution. That will be very complex solution. But when you use a research and development, and this at least, you know, R&Ds, pharma R&Ds or formulation development R&Ds. Second is research and development. The second part which need the scientific principles to be used, science to be used, and then you should work or resolve the problem or develop the product. I told that what happens if you use a trial. I always said trial can fail. But when you plan the experiment, experiment can't fail because the objective of experiment is a knowledge gain. Whatever the experiment you do, there is some knowledge. Only thing you should understand, what do you mean by experiment? Are you satisfying the principles of experiment? And I'm sure that Dr. Sawan can agree that we have been never taught what is an experiment. So that's why we plan the trial, and then it takes and you the miss on the most of the knowledge gain which you do. In the pharma, I always say these three parameters you have to satisfy. Whatever the problem you solve, whatever the product you develop, one is a quality, second is a safety, third one is efficacy. Safety should be there, efficacy should be better. If you are developing some product which has the activity less than paracetamol, why it should be approved? It will not be approved because it will be compared during approval with the existing gold standard in particular therapy. So that's why it should be more efficacious than currently approved drugs. Quality, it should satisfy the requirement of quality parameters for particular dosage form or particular process requirements. So these three things should be considered whenever you give some solution or develop a new product. During quality product, what do you mean by quality? Quality means whatever the product which you are developing, is it suitable to do its function? Suppose I told that I want rapid absorption tablet. Is it giving the rapid absorption? Or that functional, what is the requirement? That should be added to the product. Then process, whatever the process required to manufacture this product, I told that four parameters is required for any process: stable, controlled, predictable, and capable. Stability, whatever the product you are developing, is it stable? See, now if you are going through the current happenings of vaccines, there are many players or front runners like Pfizer and Serum. Pfizer's problem is the stability because it need minus 50 to minus 80 degrees Celsius for storage. If you take a Bharat Biotech, which is ICMR and IIV Pune's collaboration with Bharat Biotech, it needs 2 to 8. So in terms of stability, that also gives flexibility and easy to use if your product is stable at a slightly higher temperature than your competitors. Like suppose you were making some injections which needs currently 2 to 8 storage, 2 room temperature. These are very simple inventions. They are not innovation, I'm saying invention. There is a difference between innovation and invention. This invention, why it is simple? You take that molecule which is unstable at a higher temperature. I'm telling practical example. So where people converted like a latanoprost eyedrop, these are very hydrophobic and high partition coefficient drugs. So take them in lipid and make lipid be solution. Maybe additional drug will be required to create the concentration gradient as compared with the solution. So those ophthalmic drops can be used at a normal temperature. So here it gives you the mileage that it is stable at higher temperature, which adds utility during the use to the patient. It removes the cold chain requirement during transport, during storage, before administration, right? And even like ophthalmic, it goes to the hands of the patient. Patient should store it 2 to 8, which is most of the time is missed. Then drug might degrade during the use. So the efficacy will never be achieved. So there are a lot of problems if the product is not stable at a slightly higher or the normal room temperature. This I can convert. Okay. Now, when we see the problem in ideation, I have listed that where this idea and problem can be come or the considered. One is the improvement. In an existing product and a process, if some improvement is required, like I will give some practical examples where I worked. Process improvement. There is one product by Abbott in our market, Stemetil MD, prochlorperazine malleate. When I joined this process for test masking, it's a mouth dissolving tablet. Its process for test masking was by ion exchange reagent, and that process total time was 38 to 40 hours. Now we got that problem that how can we improve this process? So we considered the chemical nature of a drug, basic in nature, lot of trials, because again we have to consider all the parameters, scalability, manufacturability, everything. So we moved from ion exchange to the polymeric adsorption. This was the slightly new, but which is commonly used in most of the journals it is published. We took a carbopol, we add soap, we added additional polymer, EPO, and we developed this product which reduced the process from 38 to 40 hours to 8 to 10 hours. So this type of improvement can easily be thought of, but you should understand that subject, that process, or that area knowledge, like a test masking, its chemistry, polymer's chemistry, so product's chemistry, and solving and converting into scalable process. So this improvement can be done. I will come to the questions or suggestions from Dr. Sawant that how to identify the problem. Second is a problem. If there is some problem existing, somebody comes to you that, okay, I want to develop the mouth dissolving tablet for some bitter drug. Now this is a ready-made problem which is coming to you. So how can you develop the test masking? You can develop it easily, right? Either the problem can be solved by at a particulate nature or maybe the bulk nature where we use the sweeteners and other things. Then you can give the solution to the problem. New product. Altogether, you are developing a new product. So this is mostly the part of in a pharma, part of a drug discovery, where they develop the new product. Or for part of formulation development, we can develop a controlled release or some drug delivery system. There we can develop the new product. Then improving the patient compliance. Can the patient compliance is in 2-3 things. First one is easy to administer. Second, minimum administration. And third, whether he's getting or whether his unmet medical need is satisfied. Like I told the first example, suppose you are getting asthmatic attack and if inhaler is available, maybe dry powder or the metered dose, he can get the relief. Second, can he have the once in a month injection that will reduce the dosing frequency and that will be the patient compliance. Then it's easy to administration. So if he can have the like unit doses where you will not forget, there whether the marking is there on a day wise, there you can add the patient compliance. And last problem is regulatory compliance, that okay, suppose the agency told that this product is not approvable, there is issue, then to comply it, that will also the problem and we have to resolve it. Okay, I will take it. So you can classify your problem in this area. Then when you develop the problem, you have to always consider quality. Quality means three part: functional, stability, and its process. Then it should have set specification, and based on that, it should be stable for not less than at least minimum, bare minimum is 1 year, comfortably 2 years, and greater than 3 years is excellent. So when you work on any problem or idea, we have to consider this aspect. What is the chemistry around it? Second, what is the physicochemistry? What is the physicochemical nature of this environment, product, idea, process? Third, how it is going to act after administration to its action on your receptor. Like you are taking a metformin tablet. Now you have to understand how metformin will go in a body and what is the disease requirement. Nowadays metformin is commonly used. It is a hydrophilic drug, highly water soluble drug. And it is, we are taking it as a modified release. But when you actually study its physiology, pathophysiology, absorption principles, central compartment, peripheral compartment, pharmacodynamic requirement. Whenever I was doing due diligence for one of the product developed based on metformin, based on data, it come to know that IR tablet is more effective than modified release, because when this drug goes inside the body, as being a soluble, it rapidly goes into dissolution. Then it got absorbed also, because concentration gradient is very high for IR tablet. And once it enters in a blood or the central compartment, from there it can be pushed in a higher extent than modified release tablet in the peripheral compartment, means the cellular level, where there is a need for this drug for the its action. So hydrophilic drugs, there is a problem, it cannot go in a peripheral compartment. So when you design the technology for paracetamol or for metformin, you should consider all these things so that your technology will work and you will not miss the end action. Then is a mechanics. Mechanics means during processing, under pressure, during compression, how it will work, whether it will be stable. Then environment. Environment for us is, one is the temperature, and second one is the humidity. Third one is a water sensitivity, where it is more stable. And if it is more stable, then you have to be huge investment and problem for processing, for development, as well as use. So So when you develop, you consider these five aspects so that your idea and problem will not miss any required outcome after the completion of development, completion of the product, right? It should have not happened that, okay, you develop everything perfectly and then somebody asks that, okay, can you explain me this part? So it can be easily explained if you inbuilt this requirement during initiation, during initial part of a development, so or experimentation, so that at the end you will not face any problem. Now, all these properties and the problems, first we have to classify where it is related or correlated. Now we will give the example. I want to develop the dispersible tablet. Drug is slightly bitter. Where I should work? I should work at a bulk level, particulate level, or molecular level. Definitely, I will work at a bulk or sub-bulk level, in between particulate and a bulk. I will use a good diluent or the sweet diluent, and I can develop the dispersible. But if I want to develop the mouth dissolving, then I want to should go to the particulate level coating. Or ion exchange regime, polymeric adsorption. Again, I want to develop mouth dissolving in a minimum weight at 100% because particulate cannot be 100% face masking. Then I have to go on a subparticulate. So subparticulate, then you can use a complexing agent where you can reduce the dose of the tablet maybe by 100% going from particulate to subparticulate. Again, 100% moving from bulk to particulate. So first correlate what is my problem and where it is related. And what are the other parameters affecting molecular level? Suppose my product is not stable in a solution state. I want to improve its stability. Then at what level I should work? I should work on a molecular level, or going beyond, I should work at energy level. Suppose I am getting a degradation. So I should consider that, okay, degradation can be reduced if I don't use a steel surface, because I will not get the element in a trace level. So my oxidation potential will not be increased. So you, whatever your problem, in these three things, you should be able to classify. So based on that, you can target that where I want to act. Suppose I want to improve the solubility. So solubility is a property which comes under molecular. So I have to play with the molecule, not with the particle size. If I want to improve the dissolution, then I will play with the particle size. If there is a flow issue, then I will work on a bulk size. I will compact it, improve its bulk density. So your problems and your ideas, first classify what type of level of your property is a bulk, particulate, or molecule. To what level you have to act, and then classify, is it physical, physicochemical, chemical? In a pharma, mostly we are in physicochemical and chemical, and then this property should be well measured. Understand that measurement, is it measured or derived? Measured means hardness is measured, weight is measured. But if you are determining the assay or drug content by gravimetry or titrimetry or HPLC, this is a derived. Because you are treating your sample, then giving it to HPLC. But when you go parenteral, parenteral means in solution state, becomes a molecular or the particulate in a nature. So you have to classify that or my dosage form, which are the major properties. Then I will just go through one of the technologies just to get at how I worked or we worked as a team and what is the science. Because see, without science, that idea, if it is a result, it doesn't carry the weightage. So what are the problem, or you can say the improvement, to develop the lovenascan tablet with the rapid onset of action, which is unmet medical need in acute pain management. Rationally, mostly all NSAIDs are weakly acidic drugs, poorly soluble in acidic pH. All are having Tmax greater than 45 minutes. For acute pain management, parenteral route is the only option. Variability is observed in the PK profile, which results in patient-to-patient effect. So this was the rationale, what is the problem and what we should do. Then we saw the molecule. Chemistry side, I don't understand much. But based on this parameter, you can say that Tmax is 1 to 2 hours. LogP is slightly higher and solubility is less. But being a weakly acidic drug, it was having a poor solubility in acidic pH. So if drug is having poorly solubility in acidic pH, then it has a problem that it cannot go in a solution rapidly in a stomach. That's why its gastric emptying is delayed. Gastric emptying is delayed because unless it is converted into solution, IMMC, that is interdigestive magnetic motor complex, will not allow it get emptied into the intestine. So this is a physiological concept, that how gastric emptying works for poorly insoluble drugs. So here our basic was to convert the drug in rapidly solution form, but keeping it absorbable form. Remember, everything solution doesn't mean it is good for absorption, right? And that weakly, weak electrolyte drugs, when they goes in a solution, means they goes by ionization, then they are converted into charge species, and where they compromise the absorption. So then we started with the wet granulations, and there it's a very simple technology, pH modulating agent, sodium bicarbonate and fumaric acid, and one water uptake agent which can absorb the water in a tablet formulation. So is with this combination we developed it, the technology and how it works, that is ultra fast activated dissolution, because that disintegrant absorbs the water. Then sodium bicarbonate and fumaric acid can form the effervescent mixture at a tablet level. It is just conversion of effervescent tablet into technology. Then this disruption of boundary layer, that all this diffusion layer around the particle and molecule get disturbed. And that's why that dissolution is fast and independent of MMC, that is a migrating motor complex. So once it is converted into solution, that rapidly empties. Going in stomach is not for absorbing from stomach. Going in solution rapidly in stomach is for rapid gastric emptying into the intestine. And remember, drug is absorbed from intestine only, very minimum, which has no meaning for therapeutic outcome, even if it is going to absorb from stomach. Because the cell linings are very tight to allow the drug in the body. At the same time, surface area and residence time is also less. And because it is going in solution rapidly, it forms higher concentration gradient. Because the drug, only extent doesn't matter, rate also matters. If rate is fast, concentration gradient will be more. If rate is slow, concentration gradient's impact will be less. Because at that particular time, how much drug is available decides how much drug will be absorbed based on Fick's first law of diffusion. So we have the short Tmax, Tmax reduced, so onset can be fast. We got a rapid peak effect, and we got a reduced intra and inter-subject variability. And this has been well tested on by human studies. And if you see Tmax, you see the variation from 0.5 to 2.3, which we reduced 0.3 to 1. So within 15 minutes, you will get the Tmax, and within 10 minutes, you will start getting the relief in a pain. And even if you see the Tmax, it's 788 to 1098. Now there we go. Regulator asked us a question for safety, but fortunately this product was available in a solution form. So that's why we didn't get any issue, and this product is in a market doing good. If you get this surge dose Lorset SD tablet, it is good for migraine, dental pain, and migraine based on the stability, and also good for joint pains. And additionally, we also explained this effect AUC. It's called as a partial AUC, 0 to T, 0 to 20, 0 to 30. Why I'm explaining that one problem we solved simply on using some excipients is the composition or the product improvement. But you should add all the relevant science to explain, to convince, so that it increases its utility. So now this is all how we develop the product. Product is successful. Afterwards, we got a problem. We got a complaint that there is a bulging in a blister's pocket because of sodium bicarbonate and difficult to maintain the lower RH during the production. So mechanism is sodium bicarbonate presence of minute amounts of moisture and acid. It immediately effervesces. And this is chain reaction. Once effervesces, water will be generated, and again it will continue the process. So it is to give the further catalyzing presence of higher temperature, and due to it become as unstable, it was a bulging. So then how we resolve? We have to see the science, what is available in the market. So there is one surface modified sodium bicarbonate is available. It's called as Eper Soda. So surface modified sodium bicarbonate with a desiccant skin of sodium carbonate. So if you see, this outer ring is sodium carbonate and inside is sodium bicarbonate. So sodium carbonate is stable towards heat and it will not undergo any change. Sodium bicarbonate will decompose into sodium bicarbonate, water and carbon dioxide at a higher temperature. So they used to take a sodium bicarbonate, pass to the higher temperature, and you will get a sodium carbonate at the external surface. So the moisture sensitivity and temperature sensitivity would be reduced, and it will prevent the premature effervesce by reducing the moisture sensitivity of the formulation, improves the finished product stability, and you can manufacture this product with a normal RH of 40, 50 or 55%. So here we reduce the bulging even at 40 degree. We converted this product from wet granulation to direct compression, and manufacturing from previous less than 30%, we moved it to 40 to 45, which is the regular manufacturing RH conditions for solid dosage pumps. So this was the example of product and the problems arise due to it. So this was my presentation for ideation and problem solving. Now to answer the other what Dr. Sawant told, that how to identify the problems. There are two, three things. when you read the journal, when you go through the your publication journal, right, as your faculty, every year they are working on some area, they have the expertise. From that expertise, they can very easily come out what new we can do to resolve the existing limitation. That, okay, if we, instead of doing this thing, if we can do this way, we will get the improvement in either quality, safety, or efficacy. That is the one way. Second, when you read the journal in a publication, whosoever has published, there might be some limitation which you can see and which you know that, okay, I can work on it. So work on it may not be for publication, but for converting into solution as a commercial solution, right? It might not be patentable, it might not be publishable, but it is, if you can resolve the commercial issue. Like nowadays, this processing like diclofenac or paracetamol or metformin required interns. Nowadays, people are coming with directly compressible granules. Now you will ask me, what is new in that? It's not by dry granulation. At its subparticulate level, based on some polymer and drug interaction, not molecular level, subparticulate level, they have converted only with one excipient and one drug in a free-flowing, directly compressible, and even controlled release granules, so that you just take a granules, compress it, product is ready. So such a simple solution can always be thought of once you really go into your subject area and come out that, okay, if I do this, these are the issues which can be solved. And then second is, then you can take the opinion, not on how to work or how this thing, if I do this, does it has the value? It's called dipstick exercise. In particular, suppose in a formulation, I am available if you want that, okay, in a formulation, I am doing these things. So will it solve the unmet need or the purpose, or will add some value to a particular process of the product? Second, if somebody comes to you that, okay, I have this problem, can you resolve? So then that is a very easy thing. If somebody comes with a problem, then another problem is, do you have expertise in this area? Right? So that expertise should be up to the mark at the level of wisdom that, okay, I can easily convert, or I understand the subject, right? Understanding is not reading. I always, in the statistic terms, I always say there is a data, there is information, there is a knowledge, and there is a wisdom. If you just know you are teaching a subject, that is at the information level. And really, if you are able to convert into knowledge level, then you will yourself, you will get a problem. No need to search at or ask that where I will get a problem. If you really understand that topic at a knowledge level, you will get a problem. You will come up, okay, I can do this way, I can do that way. And once the knowledge is there, then you can resolve somebody other's problem also, if they come to you. And these are the two ways which I foresee that how we can identify. And most of the problems, there is a very simple solution. Simple doesn't mean easy. Simple means if you really think on it. I can do some example. Last year, there was a complaint that the manufacturing in one of the products, we got a specialization. That problem was after adjustment of pH, we got precipitation in one injector. It is in solution form. When I saw all the process, during adjustment pH, it was got 5.8. But when it cooled down, it got 6.3, and that drug precipitated out at a pH greater than 6. When I saw, I evaluated it. He told that I have, that operator or supervisor told me I adjusted the pH very well. Then I went deep to the problem, then identified that he might not have checked the pH during adjusting the heat or temperature. It means he adjusted the pH not around 25 degrees. Then I did experiment in R&D in the lab, and one principle I was knowing that when what Dr. Sound told, that I read physical pharmacy a lot, that pH and temperature, there is a correlation. If you adjust and check the pH above 25 or 30 degree, your pH will not be stable. And because your activity is not normal, so you have to bring those any solutions, any systems pH temperature to near 25, and then you have to adjust it. So just by reducing the temperature, bring it to 25, see the pH, and then add sodium hydroxide or the hydrochloride to adjust the pH. So these are the very simple things. So if you resolve, understand first, and then resolve it. And when you get any problem or idea, first check with the 360. You are solving the problem, first thing, solving a problem is you are bringing some change. That change should be evaluated 360, because when you are solving one issue, it might create another issue, right? It's like a allopathic treatment. If you want to resolve one thing, you have to take care of other things, right? You want to treat a patient with a higher antibiotic, but you should know that what is his kidney function. So when you are adding some change, it should be thought of a 360 by all angles, so that your solution will be good to use and it will come through. Second, how to first estimate your problem. And for problem estimate, you can use a Six Sigma methodology. Like define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. That any process or any improvement, if you pass through these steps, every step has some requirements, but if you pass through define, measure, analyze, improve, and control, then I think you can really understand your problem, and whatever the impact comes out of the solution which you are giving will be well evaluated. If you go through this stepwise, this is scientific steps, but definitely it is based on the statistic. But go through it so that process and product improvement can pass through the Six Sigma methodology. And this is all from my side. If there are any questions, I'm open to answer.
Okay, session is open for questions from the participants. You all are requested to get your doubts clear. All participants are requested to mute their mic because there is some disturbance. all participants are requested to ask the questions. Radha, you have a question, I think. Please unmute yourself and you ask your question directly.
Hello, Dr.
Arpana. Hello, yes, sir.
Okay, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay.
Sir, before anybody asks, like, I have one general question.
Okay.
Like, sir, our MPharm students as well as PhD students work on good research topics, actually. Before they start with the work, they search a lot and they work on the good topic. They get the good publications with a good impact factor. But I don't understand where they lack in industrial applicability, sir. Why those projects or those research paper, those dissertation work is not industrial acceptable? Where they lack, actually? I wanted just your guidance on that.
See, one is to do the work. Okay, the work is good. It is publishable. You have done some research on it. But have you tried that really that is the current unmet need? Unmet doesn't mean it meant to the industry, to the patient, to the process. Whether that your improvement really is giving or adding the value to the process or a product, and whether there is a significant improvement.
Okay.
That you need to check. Maybe Sutik side or the drug delivery side, I can give you the guidance. But for other side, you have to then contact the experts from industry that really is it useful. And second, you just see really what you are publishing is really novel.
Yeah.
You can just check what is the existing state of understanding and the technology which is available. If you are above that, or people might have resolved the same issue by some effective means. That's why that probably good publication doesn't have the commercial or industrial value and utility.
Yeah, correct.
So if they can check it and then or before publishing, even if they can check it, that will add the value to the their research. But that should be weighted through all the angles.
Thank you, sir. Sir, Radha has questions. She has posted a question.
Okay.
How to tackle and troubleshoot interdisciplinary and multitasking problems? Yeah. I'll repeat the question. How to tackle and troubleshoot interdisciplinary and multitasking problems?
Radha, am I audible?
Yeah,
you are audible.
Sir, so yeah, actually ma'am have repeated the question, but one also I want to add that acquiring knowledge about that field is a better deal, or you have to hire the persons better, means to tackle interdisciplinary problems.
See, all the problems, most of the times, are interdisciplinary in nature. I cannot see or resolve all the problems only based on physical pharmacy or the pharmaceutics. Or so you have to see all the angles in 360, the multidimensional, multi-layered. And I will suggest, because problem is there, you cannot acquire the knowledge. It takes a lot of time. So it's better jointly if you can work with the expert from other field, that will add the value and you can resolve the problem in a better and with a minimum time. So this problem should be resolved taking all the expert working as a team or co-author, co-member, and resolve the issue. Because of most of the times problems are multidimensional. So you need a multiple experts or the expert from other areas, and then go ahead. Hope I have answered your question.
Yeah, sure, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Anyone else has any doubt or problem? Please unmute yourself. Yeah, you are audible, but little louder. Supriya madam wants to ask question. Yeah, Supriya madam.
Okay. Sir, my question is related to the herbal medicine actually. Sir, as you know, this herbal medicines are nowadays are rising worldwide, but the major issue is regarding the quality issue, which I have actually made this issue in two forms, like external and internal issues. So I would like to external issue like contamination with respect to the toxic metals, pesticides and microbes, and even as it is a herbal medicine, a lot of adulterations and misidentification.
Okay, madam, I think I am not clearly audible.
Hello?
But your voice is not clearly audible. So you, Dr. Arpana, can you repeat her question?
Yes, sir. I'll read out her question. Herbal medicine. No. Is it okay, Supriya madam, if I read out
your question?
Herbal medicines acceptance has risen worldwide and their increase in usage makes safety issues important. Many adverse events of herbal medicines can be attributed to the poor quality of the raw materials or the finished products. Quality issues of the herbal medicines can be external and internal. So she has quoted some external issues like contamination, for example, toxic metals, pesticide residues and microbes, adulteration and misidentification. And internal issues she has quoted are complexity and non-uniformity of the ingredients in herbal medicines affecting the quality of herbal medicines. So,
sir, I would like to know how we can tackle these issues with respect to the quality.
See, all these parameters, what you are saying, internal and external, these are the parts of the quality of any product. Where I explained quality, safety, and efficacy. If there is any problem in quality, it will affect safety, it will go in efficacy also. So to answer your question of external, right? Sorry, internal, that is due to variability of a natural content, right, in a product. So when you study it, you have to study the different levels that, okay, suppose your natural ingredient in your product, sometimes it is 8%, 12%, 15%, 20%. Have you studied it at 8 to 20? And is there any significant difference? So there you should have the limit that, okay, if it goes pain below 10%, it will not give the therapeutic effect. Then in a quality specification during initial, before releasing a batch for use or clinical use, your input material should satisfy this requirement greater than 10%, below 20%. So this study should be done and limit should be established. Now coming to the external, adulteration, mostly what happens is the heavy metals impurity, contamination from pesticides. So during collection or during cultivations, or from where you are sourcing, there all these standards should be in place that they should during cultivation, they should take care that all these things should not appear in the raw material before converting into product. Like we also manufacture and develop the herbal products, but you have to standardize the process and remove this adulterant either at the stage of cultivation or at the stage of processing. Like a papaya extract, that carafil which we use for the dengue, that is our one of the biggest product. So there we have to give the limit for the major ingredient, or we call it as an indicator, that it should be within a limit so that your therapeutic efficacy will always be assured. Right? So at both the things, you have to set the standard, and whatever the standards you have set for safety as well as efficacy should be well evaluated. Then it has some meanings for a therapeutic outcome also. Am I right?
Supriya madam?
Is it okay, Dr. Supriya?
Oh, yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you,
sir. Has anyone else a doubt to ask? You can raise your hand or you can post in the chat box of this workshop.
I think questions are over, I believe so.
Sir, I have one specific question to ask. Shall I ask you, sir? Bol dene, sir.
Yeah, of course.
Sir, actually, nowadays people are working on, like, focus has been shifted on the COVID vaccine and COVID treatment medication. People are working on dry powder inhalations using remdesivir. But I think in this situation, the efficiency and performance of the lung is compromised. So, will it be a good option to switch to the DPI for the treatment of lung infections and all, where the performance and efficiency of the lung is compromised?
See, first identify this COVID-19. I am not expert in pharmacology or other area.
Hello,
am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I am not expert in pharmacology or to understand the disease or pathophysiology, but as a formulation scientist, I will see that if you want to develop dry powder where active participation from patient is required to inhale, right?
Yeah,
inspiratory flow should be there, then only you will get fine particle dose deposition as per requirement, right?
Correct.
And there should not be variation.
Yeah.
Third thing, do you think this COVID-19 or what you called as a coronavirus, will it be only in a lung?
No.
No. It will be in a systemic also, right? Blood circulation. Do you think that that much concentration can be achieved effectively by this route over the parenteral route? Because most of the time for COVID, we consider that patient can be admitted for 14 days or 21 days, right?
Yeah.
So is this blood concentration what is achieved by dry powder will be sufficient? And third is, if this is not achieved and infection is all over, then you see really is this route is rational one.
Okay. Yeah. Correct, sir. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I think there are no more questions. I hope I assume there are no more questions. Snehal, you can continue.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, sir, for your guidance. Now, I hand over the session to Master Jayesh Mahajan.
Good morning, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes.
Today is 20th December 2020, that is 5th anniversary of Paris Climate Change Agreement. Their participants, universities are the centers where the youth are bubbling with ideas for change. Change towards the better future. Recognizing the urge need, Terra Technology Education, Research and Rehabilitation for the Environment. Policy whose motto is to think is good, but to act is better. Terra Policy Center Smart Campus Code Network, that is determined to unleash the high octane energy of youth in educational institutions. It is therefore bunching net zero initiative to achieve carbon neutrality in university campuses. So let's take a carbon neutrality pledge for our institute, Srimati Kashiba Nauli College of Pharmacy Campus, Kodwa Campus, Not Zero, Net Zero. Now I request all the student participants to on their audio and video and stand up as per possible and keep their right hand parallel to the ground underline. I repeat all the participants. Switch on their video and audio. As we have to start our pledge, so please keep your right hand parallel to the ground in a straight shoulder line.
Simultaneously, I'm sharing the pledge PPT. You all can follow Jayesh.
All the participants have to repeat after me. So please unmute yourself. Start, ma'am.
Yeah. You can start.
VSTES Srimati Kashibai Nawle College of Pharmacy, Kodwa Campus.
VSTES Srimati Kashibai Nawle College of Pharmacy, Kodwa Campus.
Are determined to change ourselves. By undertaking actions before telling to others. Recognizing climate change is a planetary challenge of our generation. And the dire need to take urge actions to mitigate it. Noting that climate change is running faster. Then actions by humanity.
Pushing the whole planet Earth
into existential crisis. Acknowledging the warning by intergovernmental panel. On climate change to limit the rise in temperature. To 1.5 degrees Celsius or not more than 2 degrees Celsius.
To 1.5 degrees Celsius or not more than 2 degrees Celsius
above the pre-industrial level.
above the industrial level.
Avoid the catastrophe. Realizing that only way out of the impending climate.
Realizing that crisis
is to achieve the carbon neutrality. By 2050 or latest by 2070. Noting the opportunity of partnership. Offered by Terry Policy Center. Through its smart campus cloud network. To empower and guide us to develop the roadmap. Towards carbon neutrality. And its implementation through digital dashboard and tracking app.
We in our STES.
Shrimati Kashibai Navle College of Pharmacy, Kondwa Campus. Endeavor to have empower youth's potential.
For research and innovation.
We pledge to become carbon neutrality. Not later than that stipulated by IPCC.
Through enhancing the energy efficiency.
Deploying the renewable energy. Innovating the resources of energy like hydrogen waste and others. Encouraging the research to use digital technologies. Offsetting the carbon dioxide through tree plantation and methods. We agree to share the progress. And the case studies through SCC and Dashboard of Terry Policy Center. Pledging to become carbon neutral campus. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Josh.
Please mute your audio and please don't switch off your cameras. Snehal, you can continue.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, Jayesh. Now I request Dr. Mrs. Arpana Patil, ma'am, Associate Professor, SKNCOP, a startup activity coordinator, to take over the session and propose a vote of thanks.
Thank you, Jayesh, and thank you, Snehal. Good afternoon, one and all. As a, let me introduce you all to the competition which we have arranged as a part of SKNCOP Institute Innovation Cell. The name of the competition is Challenge the Problem, wherein the list of the problems will be shared with you along with the Google form for the registration. You can select any problem from the list and brainstorm for the possible solution, or it may have a single problem may have multiple solutions to the selected problem or challenge. You have to submit the solutions to the problem through the above Google form, which will be shared with you in the WhatsApp group by today evening or at the max by tomorrow morning. I'll just share the guidelines for this competition. You can just go through the guidelines, which I'll be sharing in the WhatsApp group also along with that form. So register the for the competition using shared link and use the same link to submit your solution to the chosen problem. This activity you can do in a single or in a group of two students only. The list of the problem or challenges is shared in the Google form link itself. Use appropriate code, because to those challenges a code will be given, and please select the appropriate code of the problem while submitting the solution. Submit solution within 48 hours of the registration, or once you receive the problem, or once we activate that link. Okay, solution should be concise, it should be clear, it should be innovative, and it should even be original, and describe it in not more than 500 words. The five shortlisted contestants would be intimated by Friday evening, that is on 18 December 2020. The shortlisted contestants should present their solution in front of the jury members on day two of our workshop, that is our next Sunday, 20 December 2020. So there you have to do the presentation of not more than 10 minutes, 8 minutes of presentation and 2 minutes of question answer by jurors. For this, you should prepare the presentation with not more than 8 slides. And from this presentation, the top three contestants will be declared the winners, like winner, first runner up and second runner up, and they will receive the e-certificate. Okay, I think all guidelines are clear, and please participate in maximum number. Okay. Sir, shall I proceed for the last part of the our workshop? That is
one time. Yeah, please.
Yeah, thank you, sir. So let's come to the end of today's workshop, and it's a beginning of our day two of the workshop that will be held on the next Sunday. Honorable Principal Dr. S.D. Sawant, sir, Dr. Sanjay Boldane, sir, our most valued invited resource person for today's workshop, my colleague friends and dear students, I deem it a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this occasion. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion a resounding success. I take this opportunity to thank our respected Honorable Professor M.N. Navle, sir, Founder President STS Pune, Dr. Mrs. Sunanda Navle, Madam, Founder Secretary STS Pune, Mr. Rohit Navle, sir, Vice President HR STS Pune, and Ms. Rachna Navle Ashtekar, ma'am, Vice President Admin STS Navle. I would like to express my profound gratitude to our today's mentor, Honorable Dr. Sanjay Boldane, sir, Associate Vice President, Micro Labs Limited, Bengaluru, who despite his busy schedule has found time to mentor our participants through his workshop. It's always a pleasure listening to sir, and every time it adds to our knowledge. I'm sure that Dr. Boldane, sir's guidance would have sensitized our students as all the participants to identify potential problems in the society, in the profession, and efforts to solve those problems which would benefit our society. Thank you very much, sir. I would like to take this opportunity to place on record my sincere thanks to our Honorable Principal Dr. S.D. Sawant, sir, being the catalyst that inspired us to do our best and stand as a pillar of power and energy. With a deep sense of appreciation, I thank Sawant sir for his untiring efforts. Thank you, Sawant sir. Sorry. I would be failing in my duty if I forget to mention Dr. Vandana Nikam, Madam, Convener, IIC, SKNCOP, Kondhwa. I request her to accept my sincere thanks for her constant support, efforts, and timely suggestions. Thank you, madam. A special mention and heartfelt gratitude to our student coordinators, Ms. Nehal Maske and Jayesh Mahajan. Thank you, both of you. Finally, I extend my thanks to all the faculty members and to all the student participants. At the end, I leave you this inspiring message by Swami Vivekananda: arise, awake, and stop not until goal is achieved. Once again, thank you all for your kind attention. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Sanjay, for sparing your valuable time. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all.